To get started, from Drive, click New, More, Google Drawing. That's going to open up a Google Drawing canvas. First, I like to title my Google Drawing file. Today, we're going to be drawing some ice cream cones. And if you notice on the canvas, we have this checkerboard pattern. I'm going to change the background here. You can do that by a right click or two finger click, background, and I choose white. You can always change this if you're going to export it. Then going up to the shapes menu, I'm going to click on the shapes and I'm going to think, how can I make an ice cream cone? So I chose the triangles. I'm not worried it's upside down because you can use this thing at the top and actually rotate it. And if you hold the shift key down as you rotate it, it's going to rotate in 15 degree increments. Now I'm choosing my color. That was the paint bucket, choose your color. And I actually want to draw 3 ice cream cones. So to duplicate, I can select it and on a Mac, hold down the Option key. Or if you're on a Chromebook or a PC, you can hold down the Control key and you can just select and drag. Here I selected them all because I want to move them over as a group. That's easier than doing it one by one. So now I'm ready for my ice cream. Again, looking at my shapes, I'm going to choose the cloud and draw a scoop of ice cream. I'm going to choose my color. I think this is going to be bubblegum. I'm going to use that same duplicate trick to get this scoop on the other cones. Holding down the Option key on a Mac and then dragging it over. Now my ice cream cones are a little too close together. So I'm going to select, highlight, and move over. If you use your arrow keys, your shapes move over 5 pixels at a time. So now I'm ready for my next scoop. Again, I'm going to use the same cloud tool and draw it. Choose a color. When I'm doing this with students, really encourage them that it doesn't have to look like ice cream that you might buy in the store. This really opens up creativity. If you ask them about their ice cream, if it's not neon colors or other colors that you don't typically see in ice cream, you get some great stories. And notice here I also kind of shifted my ice cream just a little bit so that it wouldn't be uniform. And I'm using that copy trick to copy my scoops. Now I'm ready for a final scoop. I'm going to rotate this one all the way around just because I don't want it to be too uniform. And to move it just a little bit, if you hold down the shift key, your shapes will only move 1 pixel at a time, which is great when you need just a little nudge. You have more control than your cursor. Now my cones are too close to the top of the page, so I'm going to highlight and then move them down because I want to put a cherry on top. So again, go to my shape. I'm going to do the circle. Now, if you want to draw a perfect circle, if you hold the shift key, you will end up with a perfect circle instead of an oval. Now my cherry, I'm going to go ahead and copy it to each scoop. But now it needs a stem. So on the line, I'm going to choose the squiggle or scribble tool. And here you can change the weight of it, which is that thickness. And you just press the arrow again, and that will take you back. I'm going to make it red. So I decided what weight I wanted it. Now I'm going to use the same tool to draw my other stems. Now the stems I didn't want so matchy-matchy. So I'm drawing in a different direction, but I do want the same color and weight. One final stem. If you have a shape you don't like, you can always select it, hit the delete or backspace button, depending on what device you're on. Or you can also use Control Z. That will undo your last step. Now here's me trying to maybe draw those lines on the ice cream cones that you see. I was trying different tools and I just wasn't happy with any of them. So I abandoned this idea. And that's okay. But I did want to add some embellishments to my ice cream. So that top scoop I was thinking of is chocolate chip. So choosing the little sun shape, I was going to draw it as chocolate chip. And when you're drawing small things, I recommend drawing them off your drawing a little bit and then copying them onto your drawing. You're going to have more control. And here, as I started putting on the chocolate chips, I was using that controller option drag to copy, but because the shapes are so small, not necessarily the best, because it was ending up changing the nature of the shape. You can see me struggling here with this particular chocolate chip. So instead, what I started doing is using Command or Control D. That's duplicate. And then I can use my arrows to move my chips where I want. That was actually much more efficient when you're working with super tiny shapes. And here I want this one chip to have the illusion of being under the cherry. Right now it's on top, but I'll show you how we're going to make it under the cherry. But first I want some kind of balance on these various chocolate chips. And again, I love this because you're teaching students different keyboard shortcuts. They're practicing their mouse skills. Now here, to get my chocolate chip under the cherry, I'm going to select the cherry group, and then I'm going to bring that cherry in front. So again, to get that menu, you're going to select your object, do a right click or two finger click, and then move it to the back or the front, whatever you need. So now I'm working on my pink scoop. I'm thinking of this as bubblegum. So I want those darker pink bubblegum. So I chose kind of this trapezoidal shape. And I don't want them all going the same direction. So you can use that dot at the top to kind of spin it around. And notice I also made the color a little bit darker. If you accidentally grab something and move it like I did there, it's just a Control Z. I like to call that our oopsie button. I'm going to have to go back and change those shapes because they're all facing the same direction. So again, to duplicate these shapes, I'm just using Control or Command D and then my arrows to move them around. And you can grab that blue ball on top and just kind of spin it. So the orientation of those bubblegum pieces for my ice cream will change. If you choose to do this with your class, super fun to see what the kids come up with. And a great introductory activity for the beginning of the school year. Going back to duplicating and changing the orientation of these chips. I could have also used the corners and kind of changed the size of the chips because they are all uniform. Totally up to you. I'm going to delete these. And my Google Drawing is complete.